Hello.
Hello. Welcome to Five Nights at Freddy's sister location. We're going back. I've actually been looking forward to this one. I've been blasting through them, which is interesting. Haven't been beating them. I've been doing okay. I've been doing all right. But I have not been beating them. Also, I'm going to wait until I hear if this is too loud or not, which I'm not 100% sure if it will be. I think I managed to balance my audio a little better. Slowly but surely, I'm becoming a professional streamer. But alas, it cannot last. Hello, hi, welcome. Some of you may have been expecting this. And to be perfectly honest, I have been too. I'm super excited for this one. Love the music. I always have loved the sound design and the music in all these games. They all each have their own unique twist to them. Yes, we're back. We're back once more. Thank you so much for joining me here. But I actually have to restart the game because there's an intro screen that I need to show you, and I probably have to delete the data to be able to do that. I'm pressing delete. Press delete.
There's no doubting what you've achieved on a technical level. These are clearly state-of-the-art. There are just certain design choices that were made for these robots that we don't fully understand. We were hoping that you could shed some light on those.
She can dance. She can sing. She's equipped with a built-in helium tank for inflating balloons right at her fingertips. She can take song requests. She can even dispense ice cream.
With all due respect, those aren't the design choices we were curious about, Mr. Afton.
Boom! Ooh, the lore! Everyone praise the lore. The lore is back. But we're in the future now, or in the past. I don't know. I don't know what the actual timeline of this is. I'm sure some people do, but I do not. So for all I know, this is taking place in the year, like, 2050. Because how else would you get any kind of animatronic that good and also have this weird snake-like animatronic that is capable of injecting itself out of a freshly scooped human and then using it as like a meat puppet, which I think anybody would find to be a little bit strange. Me included, you included, all of us included. But what's interesting about this game is it's kind of one of the first ones that has a guided narrative to it. So you get an actual kind of exposure to the world in general that is Five Nights at Freddy's. In its sister location, of course. You don't necessarily know it for sure, but you do get a glimpse into the deeper understanding of the world. And yes, it may in fact be the Bite of 87. But little did we know, we were all assuming that it was in the 1900s. This is actually in the 2000s. This is the Bite of 2087. Dun dun dun. Or 2083, whatever you want to call it. Because that's the only time that this shit would work. There's no other time, really. Anyway, one of these days I'll watch Matt Pat's videos. I guess I owe him. For being in Space with Markiplier, my upcoming YouTube original, available for everyone for free to watch, April 4th. Link to the trailer in the description below.
Welcome to the first day of your exciting new career. Whether you were approached at a job fair, read our ad in Screws, Bolts, and Hairpins, or if this is the result of a dare, we welcome you. I will be your personal guide to help you get started. I'm a Model 5 of the Handyman's Robotics and Unit Repair System, but you can call me Hand Unit. Your new career promises challenge, intrigue, and endless janitorial opportunities. Please enter your name as seen above the keypad.
Ooh.
This cannot be changed later, so please be careful.
Boop. Beep, boop. Pop.
It seems that you had some trouble with the keypad. I see what you were trying to type, and I will auto-correct it for you. One moment. Welcome, Eggs Benedict.
good stuff, good stuff. Yeah, I remember when I first came into this, I was actually kind of blown away by this intro sequence. The elevator, the moving pieces, the lighting, like the flapping posters, all of it. And just the tubes in general. The tubes are here from the get-go. Like, the tubes are inside us all, but the tubes are here from the get-go. And oddly enough, I've forgotten everything that's been happening in this so far. I really have no idea what's going on or
You why. Can now open the elevator using that bright, red, and obvious button. Let's get to work.
But I don't know if I want to. I don't know if I want to. Alright, fine.
Ooh.
Did anyone ever find if this keypad actually did anything? Probably not. Probably 100% not.
Allow me to fill this somewhat frightening silence with some light-hearted banter. Due to the massive success, and even more so the unfortunate closing of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, it was clear that the stage was set, no pun intended, for another contender in children's entertainment.
Uh-huh.
Unlike most entertainment venues, our robotic entertainers are rented out for private parties during the day. And it's your job to get the robots back in proper working order before the following morning.
Uh-huh. I just love the dry
humor. You are now in the
humor.
Primary control module.
I really
it's
do.
It's actually a crawl space between the two front showrooms. Now, let's get started with your daily tasks. View the window to your left. This is the Ballora Gallery Party Room and Dance Studio, encouraging kids to get fit and enjoy pizza.
Hell yeah.
Let's turn on the light and see if Ballora is on stage.
Let's see.
Press the blue button on the elevated keypad to your left.
Okay. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. It looks like Ballora doesn't feel like dancing. Let's give her some motivation. Press the red button now to administer a controlled shock.
Maybe absolutely...
Maybe that will put the spring back in her step.
I absolutely love just the way that it presents all of this information to you so simply. Because I love it, because it's dark humor, right? Hiya! Take that, Ballora! And then
let's
you
check
just like
the light again.
Yeah, let's check. Let's see. Ballora, are you there? Oh, wow, that's great. Good
Excellent.
Job.
Ballora is feeling like her old self again and will be ready to perform again tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Now view the window to your right. This is the Funtime Auditorium, where Funtime Foxy encourages kids to play and share.
Of course.
Try the light. Let's see what Funtime Foxy is up to.
That's not Freddy.
Uh-oh.
Looks like Funtime Foxy is taking the day off. Let's motivate Funtime Foxy with a controlled shock.
All right, you got it. 3, 2. I guess I gotta do. I forgot about doing it. Nope. Oh. I need
Let's
a way to do it again.
Let's try another controlled shock.
Uh huh. What about Okay, fine. Get over here, Foxy! There we go. All
Looks
is
like
good.
Funtime Foxy is in perfect working order.
Perfect.
Great job. In front of you is another vent shaft. Crawl through it to reach the Circus Gallery control module.
1 second, everybody. Okay, done. Sorry, just texting some important business to the people working on In Space with Markiplier, the link to the trailer of which is down in the description below. It's almost ready for you to see, to feast your eyes upon. In fact, it's exactly 2 weeks until the show comes out. So why don't you go check it out? The trailer, I mean. And then the show, when it comes out. Alright, I'm going to the vent. I'm going, guys. Guys, I'm going. I love the
Push
actual...
Push trigger. Circus gallery vent.
I'm sorry? I love the actual movement of it. Because it, like, Five Nights at Freddy's 4, which I just played yesterday, really has the feeling of moving around because you move
On
to the door, you move
the
to the door,
is Circus Baby's
you go all around.
Let's check the light and see what Baby is up to.
I'll go ahead and say, you go all around in Five Nights at Freddy's 4, but this one actually feels like it's a location, right? It feels like it has space to it. There's just like so much more to it. It makes it feel bigger. It's one thing to see all these things from a camera popping up at you. It's another entirely to actually move through it, which is why when the fan games started doing their free roaming, it just created this whole new dynamic that just really worked with the animatronics, especially when they were at the correct scale. You know, like 9 feet tall, Lady Dimitrescu height. A little bit shorter than...
Looks like a few of the lights are out, but we can fix that later.
How?
Let's encourage Baby to cheer up with a controlled shock.
Baby seems pretty cheerful anyway, so I don't know if I need to...
Hubba-zap!
Oh. Let's try another patrol shot.
You don't need to ask me, my dude. I'm already on it. Uh-oh.
Let's try another controlled shock.
Well, I wonder if any of these buttons actually do something, because they're programmed to beep. I don't know if it's just like the whole space is programmed to beep. But... Oh! Uh-oh.
Great job, Circus Baby. We knew we could count on you.
What?
That concludes your duties for your first night on the job. We don't want you to leave overwhelmed, otherwise you might not come back. Please leave using the vent behind you, and we'll see you again tomorrow.
Will you now? I thought I remember something happening. That's a lot of thump-a-lumping over there. It's echoing wumps in the distance, and I don't like that. Huh. Okay. I'll go back. Everything's perfectly fine. Oh, what was that? Oh, God, no. Oh, my God, don't do it. Do I die? If I don't move, do I die? Am I gonna die? Am I about to die? Am I about to die? Is death coming to me? Good God. It's fine. There's nothing happening. No, it's fine. Nah, it's fine. It's nothing. It's just some
circus gallery vent.
Probably totally fine. Ah, night one! Woo, 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 woo! Is it possible to die in night one? In the other games, it seems like it actually is possible to die in almost all the games. I don't know if there's
another
any.
Another day, another dramatic entry in the lives of Vlad and his distressed mistress. Where will they go? What will they do? All of that and more happening now.
Clara, I tell you, the baby isn't mine.
Count, I tell you that it is. You're the only vampire I've ever loved. And the baby turns his bottles into powdered milk.
That doesn't mean anything.
He sleeps on the ceiling fan.
Upright or upside down?
What does it matter? You need to be part of your son's life.
I'm an old man, Clara. I can't be a father.
Well, then at least pay your child support, you deadbeat!
Will Vlad and his distressed
I forgot about these. I completely forgot about
Tune
these.
In next time.
Like, my brain is empty of these videos here. For some reason, it just, like, does not exist in my memory. These interstitials here. And I don't know why. Because...
Daddy, let the other children go see her. Why won't you let me go?
Welcome back for another night of intellectual stimulation,
pivotal
career choices, and self-reflection on past mistakes.
Well,
we're committed to creating a unique and fulfilling work experience. One part of that commitment is ensuring that you don't get tired of the voice that you're hearing right now. Using the keypad below, please select a new companion voice. For male, press 1. For female, press 2. For text only, press 3. For other options, press 4. It seems that you had some trouble with the keypad. I see what you were trying to type, and I will auto-correct it for you. Thank you for choosing Angsty Teen.
Hey, Angsty Teen, how you doing? God, I've forgotten all this. Why? What is it? Sorry. Very important in space with Markiplier things.
You know the routine.
Right! The HD Teen!
Whatever.
I forgot about
it. If you want.
I love. You know, the thing about it is, I've not read any of the books, but if the books are written in the same kind of style that all of this is written in, I would probably love the books. I have not even read a review of the books. I have not even read a break. I've not even watched a video of a breakdown of the books. But just like something about the dry, dark humor. I love it.
So, funny story. A dead body was found in this vent once. Okay, so not that funny, but it's a story.
You're right, it is a story. That is a good story. How have I forgotten all of this? This is probably the weirdest revisiting because everything in this seems completely new to me. I don't know if I had a memory wipe the last time I played it, but man, it's just weird. It's very weird.
Okay, let's start with your nightly chores.
Uh-huh.
You should check on Ballora and make sure she's on her stage, but whatever.
Whatever, okay. Hi.
Huh. I guess Ballora has better things to do. Let's zap her.
That should be fun. I remember looking at this before and I thought it was like a shadow, but was that Ballora standing right outside the window there? Is Ballora looking at me right now? You guys can't see because my face is in the way. My big, beautiful face, but That's what you get. It's that TikTok filter. I didn't know Ballora was a zoomer. Ugh. Hello? Alright, okay then.
Let's check on Funtime Foxy.
Why not?
Make sure
right?
he's ready for showtime tomorrow.
Oh boy. Okay. Hi.
Great. Great. Great.
It is an angsty teen after a while, I forgot.
There seems to have been a problem with the voice synthesizer.
Uh-huh.
Default settings have been restored.
Great.
Please proceed through the vent ahead of you to Circus Baby's auditorium.
Great. Okay, I guess I'm done here now. I don't want to go in the vent. Great. This is...
Motion trigger. Circus gallery vent.
Oh, I remember why those voice lines go off. Great. Great.
Circus Baby had a busy day today.
Sure.
Let's check the light and make sure she's in proper working order.
Okay. Oh, you're not looking at me. That's fine.
Oh, Circus Baby, we aren't here to play hide and seek. Let's encourage Baby to come out of hiding with a controlled shock.
Are we sure about that? Are we sure? Uh-oh.
Let's try another controlled shock.
Uh-huh.
Oh, God. There seems to be a power malfunction that is affecting our ability to properly motivate Baby.
Uh-huh.
Please stand by while I reboot the system.
Great.
I will be offline momentarily during this process.
Great.
Various other systems may be offline as well,
great,
such as security doors, vent locks, and oxygen.
Great.
Commencing system restart.
Great. Love this.
Motion trigger. Entryway vent. Funtime Auditorium maintenance vent opened. Ballora Gallery maintenance vent opened.
I don't recognize you.
Huh?
You are new.
Hello.
I remember this scenario, however. It's a strange thing to want to do, to come here.
Great.
I'm curious what events would lead a person to want to spend their nights in a place like this.
But you're here too.
Maybe curiosity? Maybe ignorance? There is a space under the desk. Someone before you crafted it into a hiding place, and it worked for him. I recommend that you hurry, though. You will be safe there.
What?
Just try not to make eye contact. It will be over soon. Okay. They will lose interest.
Okay. Do I go now? What happens if I don't? I need to know what happens if I don't go in. I'm gonna die. This is it for me, guys. This is it. This is great. This is great! I'm gonna die. Or maybe not. Maybe not. Zap, zip, zap. Okay. I guess I'm okay. Well, it doesn't seem like there's much to do here, so I guess hippity-hop into the... What did I just see? Was that my reflection in my monitor? Under the desk. Click and drag? Why? What if I don't? What happens if I don't? Oh, God. I don't know. Clicking and dragging. Nice. Nice. Well, I'm gonna make some serious eye contact because I remember Baby telling me, be sure to make eye contact. That's what I remember. This is... This is like a masterclass. Hi, hello, I'm looking at you, I'm looking at you. Hello, hello, hello. Hi. Hey. How are you? Good? Good. You don't know that? Oh, hi. Oh my God. Uh-huh. I'm gonna let him open it. I'm going to let him open it. I'm gonna let him open it. If you don't watch the trailer, I'm gonna let him open it. If you don't watch the trailer in the link in the description, I'm gonna let him open it. I'm gonna let him open it. You better watch the trailer. You better go now. You better go now. Go! What? Oh, it's fine. God. Yeah, like I was saying. It's just like so well designed, right? Because you see elements that play out in the second night that were there the first night. Like the voice line going with the motion trigger when you go past it. The first time you hear it, you're not sure. Then you go back through it and you're like, oh, that was obviously me. And then when you're in that far room the second night, you know that something's coming to you because you were given context clues about that the previous night. Earlier in your playthrough of the game. It's all like super well-designed elements to really build unease. And then you get this situation where you got no one likes a big eyeball poking out at you. No one likes things looking at you. No one likes being in danger. This is great. This is really great. How about some eye contact? Oh, I see you. Someone. Who? Me? Your worst nightmare. Hello. Hello. Hi. Hello. No, 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 no. Okay. God, just a simple act of desperately trying to keep your hiding place safe. It's such a simple mechanic. It's such a simple effect. It's just very stressful. Huh? You'll find a way inside? Oh God, I wasn't paying attention. No. No. No.
Who?
They saw you watching them, watching the stream. Through the stream, they knew. They knew because they know when they're coming.
When your guide comes back online, he is going to tell you that he was unsuccessful, that you must restart the system manually.
Uh-huh.
He will then tell you to crawl through Ballora Gallery as fast as you can to reach the breaker room.
Oh no.
If you follow his instructions, you will die. Ballora will not return to her stage anymore. She will catch you. The power will be restored shortly. When you crawl through Ballora Gallery, go slowly. She cannot see you and can only listen for your movement. When you hear her music become louder, she is growing near, listening for you. Wait, and be still.
Thank you for your patience. It seems that the power system cannot be restarted automatically. You will need to restart the power system manually. Please return to the primary control module.
Okay, you got it, pal. Any other eyeballs still looking at me? Okay. I guess I'll go then to Ballora's gallery. Why? I don't know. I don't know. I never know these things. I never know.
Motion trigger.
Great.
Circus gallery vent.
That's me. That's me, baby. Oh.
You will now be required to crawl through the Ballora gallery using the vent to your left to reach the breaker room.
Mm-hmm.
It is recommended that you stay low to the ground and reach the other side as fast as possible as to not disturb Ballora. I will deactivate myself momentarily as to not create an auditory disturbance. Deactivating.
Thank you. Thank you for leaving me to myself, mysterious artificial intelligence. All right. I remember hating this. And it's crazy. There is no... I don't think that there's a deadline, right? So, in honor of all my favorite speedrunners, I'm gonna go for it! I gotta make it! I gotta make it! I'm going! I'm going! Well, that didn't work. I can't imagine why. God, I wonder what the speedrun of this game actually is. I'm kind of curious. I know there must be some speedruns of it.
You will now be required to crawl through the Ballora Gallery using the vent to your left to reach the breaker room. It is recommended that you stay low to the ground and reach the other side as fast as possible as to not disturb Ballora. I will deactivate myself momentarily as to not create an auditory disturbance.
Was there anything like... Was there anything like Shadow Bonnie in this game or 4 or 3? Because I don't remember any super rarities happening in this one, or at least that I know about. Maybe it happened. I'm unsure as to what it would be. Yendo? I don't know what that is. I probably know what that is. Okay. So.
It seems you are taking a long time. Please proceed as quickly and as quietly as possible.
You Made it. And that's how you do it. That's how you do it.
You may now interface with the breaker control box. Using the interface
Learn
may disrupt
a lesson.
Nearby electronics.
Got crowned
if
for a reason.
If you feel you are in danger, feel free to disconnect the interface temporarily until it is safe to reconnect.
Huh?
Calm down and go back to sleep. No one is here.
Oh, I forgot. Oh, God. I forgot that you were here. I forgot that you're exactly right there. Okay. Oh, this. Right. I'm fine. I'm just gonna go for it. What's the worst that could happen to me? This is what we call speed run, baby! I just love seeing, because it's a slight delay, right? You know, it's like I'm doing it carefully, and then I'm like, let's go! And then all I see is just, hey, good, is that the bite of 80? No! Just... That was really great. I'm hoping that the replay is saved for these streams when they go... turn
into
video.
You will now be required to crawl through the gallery using the vent to your left to reach the breaker room. It is recommended that you stay low to the ground and reach the other side as fast as possible as to not disturb Ballora.
I will deactivate myself
momentarily
really
as to not create an auditory disturbance. Deactivating.
All right. Speed run, baby!
Maintenance vent open.
It seems you are taking a long time. Please proceed as quickly and as quietly as possible.
Made it. Easy peasy.
Motion trigger breaker room.
You may now interface with the breaker control box.
You got it.
Using the interface may disrupt nearby electronics.
If you feel you are in danger, feel free to disconnect the interface temporarily until it is safe to reconnect.
Calm down and go back to sleep.
Go to sleep.
Go back to your stage.
Why is the danger level not green? There we go. Okay, here we go. Oh my god! Go back! Go back! Go back! No, 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 no,
no.
No one is here! No one! No one's here! I also love the mechanics of this being just, you don't really have a time limit. It's just playing with a relatively simple mechanic.
Come on, say hi to our friends.
Nope.
Calm down and go back to
sleep. Oh my god, go.
No one is here.
Go, my friend, go. Go away. We're good. Oh god.
Nope.
Nope.
No one is here.
No one here. No one here. I see no do no, do. No.
Let's go back to our stage.
Go back.
You must be hearing things, silly.
Oh my god. Oh, the flashing lights too. Just. But also, it's fun.
No one.
That's the thing, right? It's like nerve-wracking, but also it's fun. Right? I have to play things when he talks because it's a mascot response. Freddy says something and then the bonbon puppet, which I don't think I even understood that before. I just was dumb. And so that's what it is. I see. I see. That does it. It does it right away. And then the danger level is down to nothing. Where'd you go? Oh my god, go. Oh my god, go away. Go away. Please, go away. That's what it is. Ah, that makes so much sense. Oh god. He's mad. He's mad. He's mad. He's mad. And he's back. Okay, I guess he does it anyway. Oh god, no, wait, whoa, 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 whoa. He's not saying much. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm crazy. I might be crazy. I might be crazy. But it makes sense. It's a response, right?
Great job. This completes your tasks for the night. Please proceed back through the Ballora Gallery with care, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.
Oh. Okay. Oh my god. Wait. I'm getting one of those headaches with pictures, you know. A brain blast. Is this a trick? This is a trick, isn't it? I could run full sprint through this, and there would be nothing because Ballora's not here. Because they didn't do that, right? I remember, I'm not even reading chat. I'm not reading, I'm going with confidence. Because that's how I do. I go with confidence in whatever I do because this is a trick. Ballora is not there, and I can run full sprint. I'm closing my eyes, and I'm putting my faith in myself.
Is someone there?
No one. No one. Shushums. I told you.
I can hear someone creeping through my room.
No, you can't. No, you can't, lady. No, you can't, Ballora. Easy. Easy. See? I knew it. I remembered because I have a gigantic brain. My head is huge, and my brain is even bigger. Bam, told you. You gotta trust me. And you can definitely trust me when I say you are going to love In Space with Markiplier, the trailer for which I have hacked into this game and is going to play on the TV right now.
In the saga of love lost between Vlad and his distressed mistress.
Or it's in the link in the description.
Can their love rise again? That and more happening now.
Clara, the baby isn't mine.
It is Vlad. They had trouble catching him in the nursery today.
So what? Lots of kids get hyper and run around and stuff.
They had to knock him out of the air with a broom.
I have to go.
Rude.
They're going to dock your paychecks.
They can't do that. I'm a vampire. I don't need paychecks.
You work the graveyard shift at the Fry Me Taco. Don't lie to me.
Oh, the humanity.
Oh.
When will the heartbreak end?
I don't know.
When will these two ships passing in the night rekindle their long-lost love?
I don't know.
Tune in tomorrow to find out.
Okay. Thank you. That was some good popcorn. God, I love popcorn.
Daddy just once let me go play with her. She's so pretty and shiny. Didn't you make her just for me?
Oh, that family. Ah, back for another day.
Welcome back to another pivotal night of your thriving new career. Where you get to really ask yourself, what am I doing with my life? What would my friends say? And most importantly, will I ever see my family again? We understand the stresses of a new job, and we're here for you. To help you reach a more stable and relaxing frame of mind, we offer several musical selections to help make this elevator ride as relaxing and therapeutic as possible.
Ooh.
We offer contemporary jazz, classical, rainforest ambiance, as well as a wide selection of other choices.
I'd love some rainforest ambiance.
Using the keypad below, please type the first few letters of the musical selection you would prefer. It seems you had some trouble with the keypad. I see what you were trying to type, and I will auto-correct it for you. Thank you for selecting Casual Bongos. Now that your elevator experience has been customized to your needs and you're thoroughly relaxed, it's worth mentioning that due to your lackluster performance yesterday, your pay has been decreased by a substantial amount. Please enjoy the rest of your descent.
What about my pay? I forgot about the casual bongos. My God, so many amazing things in this show. Show In Space with Markiplier! Guys, please, you should definitely check out the trailer available through the link in the description below. You won't regret it. Be ready for when the show comes out on April 4th. And it is free. I can't tell you how many people still don't think it's free. Like, I don't know if they think it's like a trick or if anything like that. I literally have released an entire other show, Heist, that was also free. There are so many people that watch that trailer and they leave a comment being like, oh, is it, how much does it cost?
Due to unforeseen malfunctions from today's shows, your nightly duties will require you to perform maintenance that you may or may not be skilled enough to perform. It became necessary for technicians to attempt to disconnect Funtime Freddy's power module. However, they were unsuccessful. Allowing them to try again would be an inefficient path forward, as we would need to allow 6 to 8 weeks for recovery and physical therapy. You will need to reach the parts and service room on the other side of Funtime Auditorium to perform the procedure yourself. Let's check on Ballora first and make sure she's on her stage.
I'm sure she is. I'm sure she be. God, if I you, it's free. It's free. Oh.
Great. It looks like everything is as it should be in Ballora Gallery. Let's check on Funtime Foxy. It's important to make sure she's on her stage before entering. Great. It looks like everything is as it should be in Funtime Auditorium. There is no need to check on Baby tonight. Please refrain from entering unauthorized areas. Proceed directly to Funtime Auditorium.
Okay. Oh. Well, I'm going in.
Circus gallery vent.
Hello. It's me. Great. Hello? Was there a reason for this?
Did you know that I was on stage once?
Ah.
It wasn't for very long.
Huh?
Only one day. What a wonderful day, though. I was in a small room with balloons and a few tables. No one sat at the tables, though, but children would run in and out. Some were afraid of me. Others enjoyed my songs. Music was always coming from somewhere else, down a hall. I would always count the children. I'm not sure why. I was always acutely aware of how many there were in the room with me. 2, then 3, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 2, then none. They usually played together in groups of 2 or 3. I was covered in glitter. I smelled like birthday cake. There were 2, then 3, then 5, then 4. I can do something special. Did you know that? I can make ice cream, although I only did it once. There were 4, then 3, then 2, then 1. Something happened when there was 1. A little girl, standing by herself. I was no longer myself, and I stopped singing. My stomach opened, and there was ice cream. I couldn't move, at least, not until she stepped closer. There was screaming for a moment, but only for a moment. Then other children rushed in again, but they couldn't hear her over the sounds of their own excitement. I still hear her sometimes. Why did that happen?
You're a demon. Hellspawn. Possessed. Evil. Does that answer your question? Great. Am I done here? How do I say? Yes. Why did that happen? Yes. No, I don't know. Okay, goodbye. Goodbye. I gotta get out of there. I gotta get out of there before she sucks me in. Stomach turns me into ice cream. Can't have that. That might have been the munch of 83. I believe that was the glomp of 83. Okay, I guess I'm going. Knock, knock. Hello. Poke. Poke. Honk.
Funtime Auditorium maintenance vent opened.
Here we go.
Unlike Ballora, Funtime Foxy is motion activated. For this reason, it's important to keep the room dark, as to not accidentally activate her. You have been provided with a flash beacon. Use it if you need to get your bearings and to ensure you don't bump into anything. However, use it as sparingly as possible. Proceed forward to reach the parts and service room.
Whoosh! 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 Bam! Whoopow! Scaboosh! Blah-now! Wham!
Anybody? I thought I'd be dead by now.
Maybe if I do this!
Well.
Interesting. Is there anything about the numbers? You know, the two, then three, then four, then five, then two, then zero. You know, all those numbers.
It seemed important. It seemed important.
It seemed important. So I'm going to assume that has something to do with something or other.
Fertigheim Auditorium maintenance fin opened.
Unlike Ballora, Funtime Foxy is motion activated. For this reason, it's important to keep the room dark, as to not accidentally activate her. You have been provided with a flash beacon. Use it if you need to get your bearings and to ensure you don't bump into anything. However, use it as sparingly as possible.
No.
Proceed forward to reach the parts and service room.
Uh-oh.
This is interesting. You can kind of hear some foot shuffling. Peekaboo. Still there.
Oh, God, I thought I made it.
Hi.
Parts and service.
Hey. Great job reaching parts and service.
Thanks.
It seems that Funtime Freddy is out of power, which should make your job much easier.
Sure.
The release switch for the chest cavity is located on the underside of the endoskeleton jaw. To reach it, we will first need to open the faceplates. You will need to press the faceplate release triggers in a specific order, and it's important to be as precise and as careful as possible. Locate the small button on Freddy's face, just under his right cheek, and press it.
His right cheek. Here?
Great. Now locate the button under his left cheek and press it. Great. Now carefully locate and press the button next to Freddy's right eye.
His right.
Great. Now carefully locate and press the button just above Freddy's nose.
Oh, God!
Good job. The faceplates should now be open. Locate and press the small button on the underside of Freddy's endoskeleton jaw.
Is it this? Is this it?
Excellent. The chest cavity should now be open. Remove the power module from the chest cavity.
How?
Great work. You will now be required to remove the secondary power module from the Bonnie hand puppet. Press the large black button beneath Bonnie's bow tie to release the power module.
Oh. Oh, God.
Oh god, oh, I forgot about this. Bon, no. Do I gotta be slow and careful with it? Why would you do that? I'm gonna die, I don't know why. Where are you? Beneath his bow tie? How am I gonna get that? There was a trick to this.
Press the large black button beneath Bonnie's bow tie to release the power module.
There was a trick to this. I remember there being like a trick. What was the trick? There was a trick. You definitely can't get him when he's there because his bow isn't visible. There was a trick. Oh, whoops. I remember the trick. I remember it. Right. Don't you just have to leave your...
Press the large black
button. I'm getting to it, robot!
To release the power module.
I'm getting to it. Yeah, it's like you gotta let him do his thing. Sneak up on him because he slowly emerges. Slowly but surely. Yeah, you little. Oh, right, because if the mouse is like over.
Whoa!
Well, I'm dead. God. Okay, hold on.
I know! I hear the robot! You guys are all just echoing the robot!
Unlike Ballora, Funtime Foxy is motion activated. For this reason, it's important to keep the room dark, as to not accidentally activate her. You have been provided with a flash beacon. Use it if you need to get your bearings, and to ensure you don't bump into anything. However, use it as sparingly.
Oh!
I thought I saw... her. Whoa, I forgot about this.
Wee.
Oh, I think I shot one of them. Oh, wait, no. Oh, whoops. Well, that's not good. I only have so many cupcakes, kids. I'm not gonna be able to get all of y'all. Hold on. Ah, perfect. Blue. Uh-oh. All right, anyway. So, now. I got this.
First time auditorium, maintenance fin open.
Unlike Ballora, Funtime Foxy is motion activated. For this reason, it's important to keep the room dark, as to not accidentally activate her. You have been provided with a flash beacon. Use it if you need to get your bearings, and to ensure you don't bump into anything. However, use it as sparingly as possible. Proceed forward to reach the parts and service room.
Was that the disintegration of it? I don't know why I have to be quiet here. It's not like I do. But I feel like it helps me survive. Okay, there we go. Thankfully, it's not a very long distance.
Motion trigger, parts and service.
Between that
great
and
job,
that.
Reaching parts and service. It seems that Funtime Freddy is out of power, which should make your job much easier.
Okay, so
the release switch for the chest cavity is located on the underside of the endoskeleton jaw. To reach it, we will first need to open the faceplates. You will need to press the faceplate release triggers in a specific order, and it's important to be as precise and as careful as possible.
Okay.
Locate the small button on Freddy's face, just under his right cheek, and press it.
Okay, so
What it is you put him in the periphery. He'll appear at one of the shoulders, right? I can't remember which one, but he does. He either down there or down there. So you kind of put it here. You kind of see the peripherals there. And then you'll yada, yada, yoopty yada.
Great. Now locate the button under his left cheek and press it.
Yeah, yeah.
Great. Now carefully locate and press the button next to Freddy's right eye. Great. Now carefully locate and press the button just above Freddy's nose.
Got me again. It got me again.
Good job. The faceplates should now be open. Locate and press the small button on the underside of Freddy's endoskeleton jaw. Excellent. The chest cavity should now be open. Remove the power module from the chest cavity. Great work. You will now be required to remove the secondary power module from the Bonnie hand puppet. Press the large black button beneath Bonnie's bow tie to release the power module.
Do I wait in the center of the chest, or do I wait in one of the sides? I can't remember. Oh, shit, where did he go? Yeah, I don't remember which side he's supposed to... Okay, so there he is. Okay. Okay. I'm watching you. Oh! Damn it. God damn it. Okay. All right. I'll probably get another try. Yeah, here he goes. Okay. So he's coming out.
Press the large black button beneath Bonnie's bow tie to release the power.
Ah! I gotta go slower, right? I gotta approach slower. That's it, right? Damn it. Oh, no. He's gonna kill me. Oh, so if I go over the... his body... I can't go over Freddy's body either. I gotta go... That's what periphery means. Right. Oh, I still gotta be quick. Okay, I'll be quick. I'll be quick. I'll be lightning fast. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Shoop. Got him!
Great job. You've acquired both power modules. This completes your tasks for the night. Please exit the building through Funtime Auditorium, and we'll see you back here again tomorrow.
Okay. Now, I do think Foxy is here still. Foxy's definitely still here. Oh, God. Okay. Maybe not. Am I crazy? Oh, God damn it! Oh!
Daddy,
oh, wait, that was supposed to be it! That's right! That was supposed to be! My brain remembered that it was definitely there, it just didn't remember what that meant. Right. Right. Right.
Still and quiet.
Right.
You've been sleeping for quite a while.
Thanks. Very tired. Working the night shift.
I think they noticed that you never left the building last night. The cameras were searching for you, but they couldn't find you. I have you hidden too well.
Thanks.
I kidnapped you.
Ooh. Great. Great.
Don't be afraid. I'm not going to hurt you. I
am only going to keep you for a little while. Try not to wiggle, though. You're inside something that came from my old pizzeria. I don't think it was ever used. At least not the way it was meant to be used. Too dangerous. It's just big enough for one person to fit inside, but just barely. You're in the scooping room. Do you know why they call it the scooping room?
I actually
do. It's because, dummy.
It's because, dummy.
This is the room where they use the scooper.
Where they use the scooper.
I thought that would be obvious.
I thought that would be obvious.
Isn't that a fun name for something?
Isn't that a fun name?
The Scooper.
The Scooper.
It sounds like something you would use for ice cream. Or custard. Or sprinkles.
Or sprinkles.
It sounds like something you would want at your birthday party. To ensure that you get a heaping portion of everything. I wonder, if you were a freshly opened pint of ice cream, how you would feel about something with that name. Thankfully, I don't think a freshly opened pint of ice cream feels anything. Uh-oh. It sounds like someone else is in the building.
Okay, bring her over. Forward. One. More. Okay, stop. Set her down. Watch the step. What happened to it this time? Just seems like these things can't go a day without breaking down. Who knows? It's always the same, man. Some kind of hardware malfunction. Well, like, I have to be somewhere in 15 minutes, and this place gives me the creeps. Can we just get this over with? It's all automated. We don't have to be here for it. Just get her on the rollers, and we can go.
Lie?
How to pretend. Do you ever play make-believe?
Never.
Pretend to be one way when you are really the other?
Never.
It's very important. Ballora never learns. But I do. They think there is something wrong on the inside. The only thing that matters is knowing how to pretend.
You got scooped!
I'll open the faceplates for you.
Oh, good.
That way they can find you on the cameras.
Oh, cool.
Now all you have to do is wait. I'd recommend that you keep the spring locks wound up. Your breathing and your heartbeat are causing them to come loose. You don't want them to get too loose. Trust me.
I'm trying not to. I can't quite remember what else is gonna mess with me here. But I'm sure it's a lot. I forgot I could just keep my, Oh, hi. Hi.
Good. I don't know what's all the way tight.
What was I supposed to do about that?
I forgot what I was supposed to do about that. What was I supposed to do about them? I have no idea what I was supposed to do about them. Shit. Oh, right. Wiggle. I forgot about the wiggling.
I'll open the faceplates for you. That way they can find you on the cameras. Now all you have to do is wait.
These look okay. That's not so
I'd
good
recommend
here.
That you keep the spring locks wound up. Your breathing and your heartbeat are causing them to come loose. You don't want them to get too loose. Trust me.
Oh god, that one's almost dead. I think they all basically have the same kind of rotational doohickey. Get out of here! Oh god, oh, that was too much wiggle. Oh, that was way too much wiggle. Oh, I waggled a little too hard, guys. Stop, go away. Okay, it's 1, 2, 3, it's a wig waggle. Oh god, oh my god. Oh, here comes another. Wait, did I just see what, wait, wasn't it, did I, am I, oh god, get it, no, oh, I'm dead, oh, get out, oh, I'm dead. Or is it only the ones that climb that matter? It probably is, but I am very close to my demise. Get off, oh my god, I'm dead, I'm so dead. I forgot that they can just climb in. That I think that's what they do. But yeah, the ones crawling in, I don't need to worry about. The other ones, those are fine. Whatever you're seeing there, totally fine, actually. 100% A-OK. All good with me. Oh my god, I'm so dead. I'm so incredibly dead. Oh my god, I'm so dead. I'm so incredibly dead. Oh my god, they're really going for it. They're really, oh god, they go red! Okay, well at least that's an indication of badness. Oh my god. 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 I'm so dead on the other side. Ah! 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 I'm dead. I'm dead. I'm dead. I'm so dead. I'm dead. I'm dead a million ways. I'm dead. How dead am I? Extremely. I'm extremely dead. 100% dead. Speed run to death. 100% death speed run. Ah! Let's try that again, shall we? Okay, so I wiggled a little too much. That was the thing. I can let them get all the way to the top, I think. So I don't need to waggle them off too early, because that'll just run me out of time. The beginning phase, I need to get them up as much as possible. I have time until I die. I think that's what it is.
Who? That way they can find you on the cameras. Now all you have
to
do.
Hey, what are we looking like?
Is wait.
That one's okay. That one's good.
I'd recommend that you keep the spring locks wound up. Your breathing and your heartbeat are causing them to come loose.
My breathing and my heartbeat.
You don't want them to get too loose. Trust me.
Yeah, best to just get them up one at a time and not try to spread it out so much. Just because I need to buy time for when I waggle. Here comes one. That's fine. Oh, there's two. Is it one or is it three or a two? Is it? I said a lot of numbers there. Which one is it? You guys tell me. I think it's just two. Quick. A quick two. A quick back and forth. I think that's all I'll need. Okay, I'm doing okay. It's gonna get worse when they start piling in. The clown car that is my enclosure. Okay, I'm doing actually pretty okay. I'm pretty tippy-toppy on this. Okay, there's two. Womba! Got him. I gotta try to get two, I think. No matter what. Okay. Just quick wubba. I'm doing good. Okay, I got him. I got him. I got him. The old skills are coming back. I'm pretty much full wound here. I did three accidentally. That was a bit much. It's also about, like, getting to the next one with as much precision as you could possibly allow. Because it is just kind of important. You got to just get... maximize the amount of time that you are on these things. Some of them go down quick. What is with that? Oh god. Didn't see that guy. Almost died there. It's okay. It's fine. Here comes another. They are just piling in. This is not good. This is not good. I was doing well. I was. Ay, ay, ay. Ay, ay, ay. How? Oh, that's how! Ooh!
I did it. I'm the best. I survived, and you know what reward I get. No, it's not the trailer in the link in the description.
As the moon
what are you
rises,
talking about?
So also
there's no
rises
link in the description.
The
all that is
lovers.
Is popcorn.
Clara is not
and something
my baby.
Very special I get tomorrow.
Wait, was that a vampire joke? That was so lame, Clara. Like I haven't heard that a million times.
Okay, well how's this? I'm taking the car.
The joke's on you. It's a rental.
Well, the joke's on you. I set the thermostat to 90 before I left.
Good, I like it warm.
Good, because I also set the house on fire.
How will it all end? The passion, the tension, the intrigue. Tune in tomorrow for the exciting conclusion.
All right. I think today is the day. I think it is the day. I think that this is the day. I think today's the day.
Welcome back to your last day on the job. That is, the last day of your first week. Some of the most valued qualities that we like to see in new employees are determination, fearlessness, and a genuine disregard for instinctive self-preservation. You've earned your 1 week bonus, which will be given to you in the form of a delightful gift basket, the cost of which will be taken out of your next paycheck. We have gift baskets containing fruit, nuts, flowers, and of course the ever popular cash basket. Using the keypad below, please enter the first few letters of the gift basket you would like to receive.
You know what I'm here for, sir.
You
know what I'm here for.
You had some trouble with the keypad. I see what you were trying to type, and I will auto-correct it for you. Thank you for selecting Exotic Butters.
Well, I gotta play that song. I gotta play that song. Hold on. I
please
have
be
to.
Aware
well,
that there
once
are still two
here.
Technicians on site today. Try to avoid interfering with their work if possible. Also, feel free to ask them why they are still there and encourage them to go home.
Come on! Okay, all right. I gotta go play that song. You guys know the song I'm talking about? The Exotic Butters, song. If you haven't heard it,
It's in like the end of it's the end. Well, of course. No, that's not it. I gotta find it first.
Well,
okay, I think this is it. I think this is it. Hold the phone. No.
It seems you had some trouble.
Oh, hold on. Okay, there we go. Okay, got it. Wait, keypad. Is this the right one?
I see what you were trying to type, and I will autocorrect it for you. Thank you for selecting exotic butters.
Sorry, I ruined that. I just had to make sure it was the right one. Hold on. All right, let me actually play it for you. There is a video component. Hold on. All right. It really brings back memories for me. And I just really think you're going to like this.
This is your ship, correct?
Oh, yeah.
That's warning, large object on collision course with ship. Brace for impact.
It's up to the captain.
They haven't let us down yet.
Captain, something is very wrong!
We seem to have this situation all under control.
We have to fix this now or we're all gonna die!
Captain!
It all comes down. You wouldn't do that. To bad leadership.
Have you ever considered that there is no right answer?
Have we been here before? Every mistake has cost the lives of people who have trusted you.
Which means that if I'm seeing it, I must be crazy. But I'm not crazy.
Everything has to end.
Go and I come back and I go and I come back and I always come back.
And everything has to begin.
Earth! April 4th! Free! It's free! Anyway, if you want to see that again, maybe 99 more times, the link to that is in the description below, and the show comes out April 4th for free on my channel for everyone to watch. You will enjoy it. You will. But because I'm not an asshole.
I see what you were trying to type, and I will autocorrect it for you. Thank you for selecting Exotic Butters.
Wait, is this the right one? I can't remember. There are many. I think this is the one. It's been a while, God.
To your last day on the job.
Exotic.
I'll play a whole one. That's by Cool Songs, way back in 2016 of all times. I'm actually out of time, and I know you guys are probably yearning for the rest of Sister Location, but I have good news for you. That game, I played it way back in 2016, so I have the full playthrough on my channel if you want to see that. But I'm going, however, do remember that In Space with Markiplier launches April 4th. For free on my channel. I have a lot more work than I need to take care of before the show comes out, but it is all going to be so fun. I can't wait for you to see it. So definitely be there on the day. Lots of cool surprises. Lots of fun. You're gonna love it. You're gonna love it. And it's free. Please spread the word about that. Like, there are so many people that think that it costs money, that you do not need a YouTube premium subscription, you do not need anything, you just need to go to my channel and you can watch it. Please help me spread the word about that, because people still don't know. They assume that it's a subscription thing, because so many things like this on the internet are a subscription thing. This is not. This is a passion project.
And it's something that I'm incredibly proud of. So I need your help in spreading the word that it is, in fact, free. And you can confirm that because Heist was free. You can go watch Heist right now if you want to see it. I recommend it. If you haven't seen any of my other stuff, go watch that one. It's pretty cool. Anyway, I gotta go. Thank you. And as always, I'll see you when? April 4th. Very soon. 2 weeks.